Hello, my lovelies. Welcome to my channel. Here we are doing the monthly reading for all zodiac signs. This is going to be for Aries, Sun, Moon, Rising, and Venus. Before we get into your reading, Aries, I just want to put out there and let you guys know, encourage you guys, I should say. First, I hope all of you guys are being safe. I hope you and your family are doing well. In these uncertain times, I encourage you guys to put love into the universe. I encourage you guys to be more compassionate, more understanding. We are living in very difficult times. And if you guys seen the videos that were uploaded for January, the beginning of this year, a lot of what was said there is currently what we're experiencing. And, you know, I think that when we're, you know, when tensions are running high, a lot of the times, anger could get the best of us. And I think that it's important to, like I said, try to be compassionate towards one another and, you know, understanding, even if you agree to disagree, you know, regardless of what's going on. I think that change always starts within us. And I think that, you know, when we look at ourselves in the mirror and, you know, try to be better humans, I think that that's something that we're lacking nowadays. And I, like I said, I think love, you know, overcomes hate. You can't fight hate with hate, because then, you know, it just creates more chaos. So anyways, let's get into your reading, Aries. Let's see what spirit has for you guys for this month of June 2020. All right, your first card here is the High Priestess. So there is a situation in regards to, perhaps some of you guys are dealing with uncertainty. Perhaps some of you guys are wanting to get some type of clarity in regards to a situation or circumstance. For others of you, you're being pulled towards being more on your spiritual side. Perhaps you feel intuitively that you're being pulled towards, you know, being more religious or being more spiritual. Or for some of you guys, it could even be seeking some type of faith, some type of closeness to that of the spirit realm. Now, the obstacle here is the Two of Wands. So for some of you guys, it could be wanting clarity or having fear in regards to relationships or partnerships. In the past, in passing, you have the Seven of Swords. So there was some type of, you know, situation that you dealt with. Perhaps there was deception, or perhaps you feel like the person perhaps that you were dealing with or that you were interested in has been keeping some things from you or hasn't been completely honest with you. Now you have the Six of Coins here. So it's a give and take type of situation. For some of you guys, this could speak about perhaps you pulled away from a connection or some type of person that you were dealing with because you felt that there was no give and take. Perhaps, as an example, you could feel like you were the one always reaching out and they weren't reaching out. And you started having doubts or started thinking that perhaps they were dealing with other people, etc. Now you do have the Nine of Swords here. So there is what's on your mind currently is a lot of anxiety, a lot of worry, a lot of doubt. You could be dealing with an air energy, Aquarius, Libra, Gemini. It doesn't have to be their sun sign. This could be their moon sign as well. But with the Six of Coins here, I feel that there is definitely a connection. Even if you felt like they're very hard to read, or if you feel like they moved on, etc. What they're saying here with the Six of Coins is that it was a give and take, but I think that for them on their part, that like that becomes very difficult. It's kind of like when you've been hurt so much, you get to a point where you're no longer like trusting people at face value. You are going off of actions, not words. And I feel that this Queen of Swords is definitely like that, or is currently dealing with a situation where it's like, to them, you have to prove to me that you're interested in order for me to be open or in order for me to come towards you. Yes, it's unfair because, you know, if you obviously didn't do anything wrong to them and they feel that way, It's kind of like you have the right to feel the same way, right? Like, you, what do I need to prove to you? You need to prove to me you're interested, that type of energy. So it's, I feel that both of you guys are being blocked, and it could be ego involved, but I feel that for the most part, for you on an emotional level, you probably felt like you felt hurt in some way, in some shape, way, or form. Like they were either taking advantage of you. This is how you viewed the situation anyways. It doesn't mean that that's how it happened, but your perception of it. Now, your advice card here is the Four of Coins. So I see you restricted in the sense of like protecting your heart, or I see you like, you know, it wasn't really moving forward, so I'm just going to kind of give up. And what they're telling you here with the Four of Coins is that you're able to attain this person, or you're able to actually create something from this connection. But I think that ego is involved. Now, you have the Queen of Wands here as well. For some of you guys, it could be that this represents your energy, but it could represent that you are the one that is extremely blocked. So it could be that you felt like you were trying to ignite the passion, trying to take flight, meaning trying to take this relationship further. But again, you probably came out pretty strong. For some of you guys, it could have been that, you know, you were extremely blunt about how attracted this person is, or how attracted you were to them. Perhaps you made, you know, you made it clear that you desired this person. So in retrospect, this could have came out as in this person perhaps thought that it was only something you were looking for that was temporary or sexual. And it doesn't necessarily mean that it could be that way, but it could have been that's how they see the situation. That's how they seen you. So that could be the reason why they decided to kind of protect themselves. They're like, okay, you know, maybe she or he is looking for something temporary, and that's not where I'm at right now. So there was a distance, or they created some type of distance. Now you also do have the Page of Wands. So I do see communication coming through. You have the Six of Wands as well. So there is victory here. Here's the thing. What they're saying is, if you're currently dealing with the person that you really are interested in, perhaps you've been nurturing this relationship for some of you guys. This could even be a friend that is very close to you, that you wanted to take it to the next level. And they're like, I see a lot of fire energy here. So I think that you were coming off, at least to them, very strong, or that you made it known that you desire them. And at this present time, with the Queen of Wands, the Queen of Swords, the Queen of Swords is a very methodical type of energy. It doesn't have to be a queen. It could be a male or female. It's a general reading. But they're very methodical when it comes to deciding, when it comes to partnerships. And if the physical was something that was very important to you, or that you made it known, or that you pretty much touched bases every time you conversated about, that could have been like a turnoff for them, because they're thinking that you're not coming from a genuine place. It's more of lust and desire. So again, if you are really interested in this person, then my suggestion would be to take the practical approach, to go out of your way to let them know that you're interested, invite them on a date, let them know or show them that you are trying to get to know them, that, you know, desire is not something that's in your mind. Although I know, you know, when you're dealing with someone you're interested, obviously that's something very prominent, but there's ways of going about it. And I think that perhaps to them, you came off too strong. Now, if you are dealing with a partner, and this is your partner that you're dealing with, perhaps they're being blocked, or they're very distant from you. And it could have to do because they feel in some way that you give more credit to the physical, meaning you're pissed, but you want to have sex with them. And it's like, well, we haven't really hashed out, you know, our issues. How am I just going to have sex with you? And they don't understand that you are fire energy. And the baby of the fire family. So you're very to the point. You're like, I want it, and I want it now. So again, if they are being more reserved, or if in fact you haven't had, you know, you haven't been physical with your partner, what they're saying here is that they're wanting communication. You have a lot of swords and a lot of wands. So communication is very important. for them anyway. So again, putting effort in trying to hear them out, putting effort in trying to understand where they're coming from. I don't want to go out there and say pretend, but sometimes, you know, it's important to connect, especially on an emotional level, at least to make them feel that they're being heard. Okay. All right, my lovelies. I hope you guys enjoyed this reading. We'll see each other soon. Bye.